students, in our last class we have discussed the preparation of Halloween games, and we have discussed it under three heads. First is from the alcohol, second is from the hydrocarbon, and third is from the halogen exchange matter. Now today we will discuss the preparation of halogens, right? And this can be done through there are two main methods. First is from the diazonium salts, and second is from the arenes, halogenation of arenes. Now, so the halogenation of arenes can be carried in two ways. The first one, the first one is the nuclear halogenation of arenes, right? So here, students, when we say nuclear halogenation of arenes, it is carried at in the dark. Nearly the temperature is 310 to 320 Kelvin, right? It is not in presence of direct sunlight, right? So here, if we take benzene, the halogenation is taking place, right? At temperature 310 to 320 Kelvin in presence of anhydrous FeCl3, or we can take anhydrous AlCl3 also. And what is the role of it? It acts as a halogen carrier. Students, so substitution will take place and we will get chlorobenzene. This is student direct halogenation, and it is the electrophilic substitution reaction, right? And here anhydrous FeCl3 is acting as a Lewis acid, and it is acting as a halogen carrier, and we have discussed its mechanism in class 11, electrophilic substitution reaction mechanism we have done. Right now, if we have excess of chlorine, right, if excess of chlorine will be there, that time, student, the chloro group is ortho para directing, so it will direct the incoming group Cl group either at the ortho position and at the para position. So it is ortho dichlorobenzene, and this is para dichlorobenzene, right? So next we can obtain the haloarenes from the toluene also. This is toluene already substituted with alkyl group. Benzene is substituted with alkyl group here. So here, when the chlorination will be carried out, same at 310 to 320 Kelvin temperature, right? Here also again just skipped out. This is the Lewis acid halogen carrier here. Here also it will be there. It will also follow the electrophilic substitution mechanism, and since the alkyl group is ortho para directing, we will get the product formed. The Cl group will be at ortho and para position, right? So this is the compound formed is ortho chlorotoluene. This is ortho chlorotoluene, and this is para chloro toluene, right? So students, this is the direct halogenation which has been carried out, right? And it is carried when the temperature we have the lower, that is 310 to 320 Kelvin, right? Now when the temperature is increased or in presence of sunlight, the side chain halogenation, students, will take place of benzene ring will take place. So Second is side chain halogenation of pairings, right? So let's take CH3 toluene here. Now it is in Cl2 at elevated temperature, that is 373 high temperature, or it is in presence of sunlight. That time, student, the side chain halogenation will take place and we will get the product CH2Cl, right? And then excess of chlorine is there. So minus HCl, this HCl will be also formed. So when Cl2 is in excess, the products which will be formed is CHCl2, right? And I'm just continuing this. Again, this is sunlight. Here also, same condition, minus HCl. And it will form CCl3, right? So this is a side chain halogenation which is carried, right? And the compound formed at one time halogenation is benzyl chloride. This is benzyl chloride, and this is student benzoyl. Right, when it is CHCl2, it is benzyl dichloride, and then it is benzo trichloride. So this is benzyl dichloride and this is benzo, so I just get it corrected, it's benzo trichloride. Benzyl trichloride, right? This is it. So this is the preparation of the haloarenes from directly from the arenes, right? Now students, we will discuss the preparation from the benzene diazonium compound. Second is from benzene diazonium salts, right? For this, student, we have to prepare the benzene diazonium chloride, and for that the process is diazotization, right? So it is the process of preparing benzene diazonium chloride by treating ice cold solution of aniline with sodium nitrite solution in presence of HCl at 0 to 5 degree Celsius. So the student, in the diazotization, the benzene diazonium chloride is formed, is prepared by treating the ice cold solution of aniline with sodium nitrite solution in presence of HCl at 0 to 5 degree Celsius. From this definition also is being asked that what is diazotization. Now we write down the reaction is NaNO2 plus HCl will give HONO plus NaCl. Now this is the nitrous acid which has been formed, right? And this nitrous acid then reacts with benzene aniline NH2, HONO plus in presence of HCl. Now student, the temperature is 0 to 5 degrees Celsius. That is a very low temperature here. It's an ice cold mixture, right? So here you will get benzene diazonium chloride formed, right, plus H2O, right? And here student, this is the compound benzene diazonium chloride, right? So it has been asked that write down the or define the diesterization, right? So you have to define it, and the reaction has been asked, you will write down the reaction. So just learn this reaction, right? It's very important here, and the HCl which we will be taking here is dilute HCl, right? And throughout the process, the reaction, the temperature will be kept low. It will be kept low, right? Comes that how we are going to prepare the haloarenes from the benzene diazonium chloride. So we have prepared benzene diazonium chloride, and now we will prepare it. So we have got here two the reaction. First reaction is Sandmeier reaction. It is Sandmeier's reaction. Here student, the benzene diazonium chloride is made to react with cuprous salt, let it be Cu2Cl2, in presence of HCl, so that we get chlorobenzene plus nitrogen gas will be removed. Now here you will keep one thing in mind, that the halogen group which you want to introduce here, you will take the copper salt of the same halide, right, same halogen atom, and the acid also. This is for the chlorobenzene, right? If you have to prepare bromobenzene, HBr, so it is here bromo group introduced, and this is N2 and plus minus HCl. So this is bromobenzene form. But if you have to prepare students iodobenzene, that time we will get it reacted with potassium iodide, and we will warm the solution, and we will get the iodobenzene. This is the iodobenzene we should be obtaining, right? So here, if the Sandmeier reaction is asked to you, you will just give the example these two. When benzene diazonium chloride is being treated with copper salt halide, copper cuprous chloride or cuprous bromide, to prepare chlorobenzene and bromobenzene respectively in presence of HCl or HBr, right? It is a Sandmeier reaction, right? Now chlorobenzene can also be prepared from the benzene diazonium salt chloride. And how we can do it, how we can prepare, so that reaction is Bahls-Steinmann reaction. Here we have benzene diazonium chloride. We get it reacted with fluoroboric acid, HBF4. This is fluoroboric acid, right? So first we will get an addition compound formed here, that is N2 plus BF4 negative. This is the complex which has been formed. HCl will be removed. This is unstable, and it will shortly break down to give chlorobenzene plus BF3 plus nitrogen. So this is the chlorobenzene which has been prepared here, right? So this is Bahls-Steinmann reaction, and it is prepared treating benzene diazonium chloride with chloroboric acid, and the temperature here again will be kept low, that is 0 to 5 degree Celsius. Right. Now, next is the modified form of the Sandmeyer reaction, that is a Gutterman reaction. So, second method of preparing the halogens from benzene diazonium salt is the Gutterman reaction, and it is the modified Sandmeyer's reaction. Here, instead of cuprous salt, we will use the copper powder. So, instead of cuprous salt, use of copper powder. So, let's see, this is benzene diazonium chloride. Its reaction with copper powder. If we have to prepare chlorobenzene, we will use HCl. If we have to prepare bromobenzene, we will use HBr. So it is in this way. So it is Cl here plus N2, and here it is bromobenzene, and this is there, right? And along with that, HCl. So chlorobenzene and bromobenzene can be prepared in this way, right? And student, the third method is from the, we can say, from the silver salts of the carboxylic acid or the aromatic acid, right? From silver salt of aromatic acid. So we have benzoic acid. So you can draw the benzene ring in this way also. This is COOG, that is silver benzoic. We get it reacted with bromine in presence of carbon tetrachloride, and here we will get bromobenzene form AgBr and CO2. This reaction is also known as the Hunsdecker reaction. So when it is name reaction is asked, you can write down this reaction also under Hunsdecker Borodin reaction. Right? This is one of the method of preparing the halogens. Right? We get the bromobenzene formula. Now student, the next is the commercial method, that is the Rashik process. Right, let me check the board is clear to you or not. Right, so it's Rashik process. So in this process, the benzene is treated with mixture of HCl, right, and oxygen reacts with it in presence of cupric chloride, right. So we take the vapors of, this is in gaseous vapors, HCl is also in gaseous state, and oxygen, that is air, in presence of cupric halide chloride, right, it has been heated. Then we will get here C6H5Cl, that is chlorobenzene and water, right. This is obtained in Rashik process, right. So Rashik process is the commercial preparation of the chlorobenzene by passing or by heating the vapors of benzene HCl in air in presence of copper chloride, right. A question can come in your mind that why we haven't used the phenol to prepare the, right, a question can be rising in your mind that if a haloalkane can be prepared from the alcohol, so why not the haloarenes prepared from phenol? So haloarenes cannot be prepared from phenol, right? And why is it so? Now if you see that in phenol, this is there. This is the phenol molecule, right? So here the phenol undergoes the resonance, okay, and the lone pair on the oxygen atom, there is a double bond right. So C dash O bond is not going to weaken up, it is going to strengthen up, right? So it is very difficult to replace the OH group of phenol by halogen atom. So due to resonance, the carbon oxygen bond student, it gets the double bond, partial double bond character, right? So here you can see that this is there, a partial double bond character arises in phenol, arises in phenol due to resonance, which strengthen the C dash OH bond and make the replacement of OH by X difficult. Right, so you can just further you can draw the resonating structure also. So here we are getting, you can see that throughout the resonating structure there will be partial double bond character, right? This is there. If you draw another one here also, there will be double bond character in C dash OH bond, right? So which will make this bond difficult to break up and to get replaced by the halogen atom. Hope so this is clear to you, that why the haloenes can't be prepared from phenol, right? Because due to resonance, a partial double bond character arises between C dash OH, which makes the cleavage of this bond difficult, right? And hence we are not going to prefer phenol for it preparation of haloenes.